What's up guys, Emmanuel here. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I want to show you how you can set up your Facebook pixel so that you can track users' activities on your website or on your online store. Right now, Facebook pixel is not the best and it's not the most effective way to track these activities when running Facebook ads, but it's the level of tracking that I believe almost everybody can take advantage of. So if you have as simple as an online store, whether you are using a third-party online store, just use a simple web builder, you should be able to install your Facebook pixel and use it during your ads. But you need to understand that a lot of changes have happened over time, like browsers having ad blockers that can affect the performance of your Facebook pixel, right? And that's where conversion APIs come in. With Facebook's conversion API, you'll be able to track events that your normal Facebook pixel will not be able to pick. But on the other hand, that's not what everybody will be able to set up. For instance, you need to have your own website for you to use the conversion API. But if you have a simple landing page, simple online store on a platform like Seller, then Facebook Pixel is the best option that you have. But the only downside is you'll not be getting top level accuracy with your tracking, especially with version 14 or later iOS devices users. Your Facebook Pixel will not be enough to give you accurate data at that level, and that's where the conversion API comes in. With just a Facebook Pixel, Facebook is able to track events from people's activities on their browsers, and a lot of issues might come in that will not allow your pixel to pick properly. But if you have the conversion API set up, then Facebook is able to track the event directly from your website server instead of the user's browser, right? I hope you understand the point. It's just Facebook's way of helping advertisers track events like this since iOS updates and all of those fight between iOS and Facebook and all of that, right? And if your advertising location is Nigeria, basically, Facebook Pixel is still a very good tracking option to use. And I believe that's because less than 10% of mobile phone users in Nigeria use iOS, right? So the number of persons who fall under this category, that's these people that have been protected by iOS changes and all of those stuffs, are very minimal, right? So if you are using just a Facebook Pixel, you will not be able to record conversion events from those devices, but that does not mean they are not going to see your ads. And also, you will not be able to retarget those people, so it will really affect your remarketing game, right? So since you will not be able to really classify them into a custom audience and retarget them with your later ads or your later offers. So if you want to get high level accuracy with your tracking, you should use conversion API. But if you cannot get all this in place, then you should be using Facebook Pixel. And I'm going to show you how you can set that up and be able to track some events and users' activities on your website so that you can remarket to them in the future. So to set up your Facebook Pixel, log into your Facebook Ads Manager and come over to All Tools here and go to Business Settings. Here under Business Settings, you want to come over to Data Sources and then click Pixels. After clicking Pixels, what you are going to see will look like this. What I have here are the pixels I've created before, but if you've not created any pixel, you are going to see an add button to create a new pixel somewhere around here. But all you just need to do is to click on add and then give your pixel a name. Let me say new pixel. All right, so you can just click on continue. So you can decide to follow the prompt and set up your pixel on your website right now, but you can decide to do it at a later time, so I'll just leave it for now. Now this is what your pixel is going to look like. This is your pixel ID, so you just need to copy, and if you're using a third-party platform for your online store or your website, or you just used a simple landing page builder, you just need to copy this ID here and install to your store or your landing page builder, whichever the case. And once you've done that, what you want to do is to click on add assets so that you can add this pixel you just created to your ad account, right? That way you'll be able to use it when you are setting up your ads. But if you don't add it to your ad account, when setting up your ad, it's not going to show up as a pixel option to use. So click on add asset and then select your ad account and then click add. That way this pixel is going to be added to your ad account. When it comes to installing your Facebook pixel to your website or your online store, the process varies depending on the platform you are using, but most times if you're using just a page builder, just need to copy the pixel ID here and install, right? But if you're using a WordPress website, what you just need to do is to come over to Event Manager. Under Event Manager, you see all the pixels you have under your ad account. You see them here, and then what you can just do is to click Continue Pixel Setup, and then you have two options: either use Conversion API or just use Facebook Pixel, which is Meta Pixel, and then you click on Connect. Now, if you can decide to install it manually using a code, that means if a developer helped you build your website, all you just need to do is to enter the developer's email, and Facebook is going to email the instructions to the developer to help you fix that up. But if you're using maybe a WordPress website, use WordPress to build your website, you just click Use a Partner Integration and then click Use a Partner. And here you can see all the partner options you can use: 3dcart, Brandzugo, BigCommerce, Drupal, Equid, Eventbrite. You can use Google Tag Manager, HubSpot, Jimdo. So just select the platform you are using, right? So for instance, if you're using WordPress, you just want to select WordPress, and Facebook is going to give you the step-by-step instructions to follow to install your Facebook pixel on your WordPress website. As you can see, all of these instructions here, you just click next, and you are going to get that done, right? And also, when setting up your conversion API on your website, just click continue. Also, I didn't mention that you need a Facebook pixel to use the conversions API, right? So that's very important. So you can just choose conversions API and then click connect. Also, this Facebook is going to give you the step-by-step instructions to get the installation done if you have a WordPress website, or you have a developer who helped you build your website. So as you can see, the process is very simple. Also, you can create custom conversions by coming over here. Come over here, you select custom conversions, you just want to click create custom conversion, you name your custom conversion, let me say new, and then you select data source, which is the pixel you want to use. Now select it, and then the event you're optimizing for, all URL, right? And then what you want to do here is to enter the conversion rules. And what this means is, before Facebook is going to record this particular event you are creating a custom conversion for, the URL of that page must contain certain characters, right? And what I mean is, for instance, if I want to create a custom conversion for this page, that means when people get to this page, I want Facebook to record it as a particular event. For example, this is the website URL for this page, so I can select unique characters on this page URL, right? So I could decide to use maybe my name here, which is Emmanuel Adanu, right? So if I pick this part of the URL and then I enter it here, so what this means is, before Facebook will pick this particular event, the user must have gotten to a page that contains this URL. And you can also add a couple of rules by just clicking on this plus icon here. And what that will mean is, the URL of the page must contain this here, Emmanuel Adanu, for instance, and then another keyword, right? So let's say I'm going to copy let's say C, and then I enter this here, right? So before Facebook is going to count this event, the user must have landed on the page that contains this URL, right? So that's what that means. And then you can enter a conversion value. Anybody that gets to this page, how much is that person worth to your business, right? So if you are trying to record a purchase event, for instance, that means what you need to do is to take the URL of the thank you page for that product, okay? Take the URL of the thank you page for that product and use it as your custom conversion rules, yeah? And then you enter probably the amount of the product you are selling, maybe 10,000 naira, and then you click create, right? So this is the new custom conversion we've created. And then you also want to add it to your ad account by clicking share, and then share with an ad account. Select the ad account you want to use. Let's say this is the ad account I want to use. So after selecting it, you click share custom conversion. So this custom conversion is going to appear on your ad account, right? So I can use it when setting up your ad. So this is how you create custom conversions with your Facebook pixels, okay? So I hope you got all of these steps. So this is a simple process you can use to set up your Facebook pixels and be able to track users' activities on your website or on your online store when possible. So I just hope you found this video helpful. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and let me know what you think about this video in the comment section. If you have questions from this video, let me know in the comment section as well. And if this is your first time of coming to this channel, you're welcome. My name is Manuel, and on this channel I create videos related to online business, and what you need to do right now is to hit the subscribe button, subscribe to the channel and turn on the bell notification so I get notified anytime I upload a new video on this channel. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.